A court in Tagum City convicts ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro, former Bayan Muna Representative Saturo Campo, and several others for taking Lumad miners in a supposed rescue mission back in 2018. They were handed prison sentences of between 4 to 6 years. Ocampo and Castro said they will question the decision of the court in all venues possible. They argued the court ignored the testimonies regarding the continued harassment of the Lumad schools by military and paramilitary forces and the danger that the students faced.
Kung sino pa yung nagtatanggol para sa mga karapatan ng mga kabataan at ay kami pa yung na-convict o kami pa yung mapaparusahan. Nagpapatuloy pa rin itong kawalan ng hustisya sa ating mga Lumad. In fact, kung maalala ninyo, more than 200 schools ang pinasara nung panahon ng Duterte administration dahil sa kung ano-anong mga pagbibintang.
The Philippine Agriculture Secretary allays concerns about the decreased revenue collection due to the government's controversial decision to reduce rice tariffs. Secretary Francisco Chu Laurel Jr. said the tariff reduction won't affect yet the Bureau of Customs collection for 2024. According to him, the customs has already collected 30 billion pesos in imported rice tariffs so far this year.
For this year, hindi dapat maka-apekto masyado dahil ang collection ng Bureau of Customs sa rice tariffs has exceeded last year's collection. So makukuha pa rin for 2024 ng mga farmers natin yung usual na nabibigay sa kanila.
4.7 million metric tons. That's how much rice the Philippines is expected to import this year. That's according to estimates by the U.S. Department of Agriculture. This figure is 1 million metric tons higher than the amount of rice the country imported last year. The report attributes this impending increase to the tariff reduction on rice imports coming into the Philippines. And with this projection, the USDA says the Philippines will remain to be the world's biggest rice importer. The local bourse rings in its third initial public offering of the year. NextGen Energy Corporation debuts at the stock market tomorrow, Tuesday. This is for 300 million common shares at 1 peso and 68 centavos apiece. Businessman Dexter Chu's firm follows Citicor Renewable Energy and Oceanagold Philippines in going public in the last 2 months. XG's initial offer is oversubscribed, which its president and CEO welcomed despite a short offer period. Mr. Eric Peter Rojas says the company will focus, among others, on energy investments in agriculture. They're also banking on expansion and acquisition to increase shareholder value.
Everything will be for projects. There will be for the solar project and the wind project, and a portion will also be allocated for acquisitions. We're also excited about agricultural technology, indoor climate farming, where we supply the power.
In an assessment of the Philippine renewable energy space, though, Rojas says there's still much to be done to ease bottlenecks, such as on securing project permits.
There's a big push, no? But there's still a lot of problems with permitting and all that, no? If these can be minimized and easier to get, then I think renewable energy will be a big thing here.